Hello and welcome to my eBay listing. This will be a test drive of the Volvo S80 D5 SE 163 Gearronic Saloon. If you'd just like to follow me through, it's a 2008 model. Right, we get one of these sort of, this is the key, there's two of them, it's like a cartridge. It locks and opens the car of course, but it also unlocks the boot. Here we are, we have a little slot here we put it in like that. And then it's in park, I'm covering my foot brake, and I just press the button and it starts. Right, we're all ready to go. It's got electronic handbrake, so I just press a button over here, it's released. And I put it straight into D, and off we go. There we are. There we go, we're accelerating now 20 miles an hour. We're just coming up to a bit of a roundabout first. 25 miles an hour, 30 miles an hour. All very smooth and effortless. There we are, there's the indicators. Again, decelerating now 20 miles an hour. It's all perfect. The car's got 2 years of manufacturer's warranty left, so if there was any problem whatsoever, even the tiniest thing, you could just simply take it to your nearest Volvo main dealer. Okay, cruising along now at 30 miles an hour. I can press the cruise button on my steering wheel, and then lock the speed, and there we are, we're doing 35 now. And there, it just keeps the speed. I can knock it off easily by pressing the cruise or just touching the foot brake. So we've got coming up now to the roundabout. While we're going along, we've got instruments here. There's the radio. It's a high performance sound.
Five of ordinary people.
Here, I'm giving four, BBC
a voice
Radio 4.
A place in history. I went to meet her in her Edinburgh studio.
We've also got a CD changer, a CD slot, and we've got on this control panel. It tells you the fan speed. So pretty much like an information centre of the interior controls. Yeah. Temperatures of climate control, which is fine. We also have on a control by my little fingers on a steering wheel, sat nav. So if I press a certain button, I become like that. Gives you some information. I then press it again, enter. It'll then start activating and finding that position.
In 200 yards, enter the roundabout and take the second exit. Take the second exit.
Okay, well I'm going to ignore her and take the, actually no, she is right, it is the second exit. Okay, that's fine. So there we are, second exit. I can switch it off any time. It's got many different uses, this system. It's called the RTI, Road Traffic Information Navigation System. It just runs off the tip of your tongue there, doesn't it? But anyway, it's the... tells you if there's traffic jammed, it'll tell you on a screen. And it's also got all the CDs, or DVDs actually, of the whole of Europe, or the whole of the new Europe. There are Poland, Romania, and things like that. And of course it's got Ireland, UK, France, so it's a really very useful piece of equipment. Next thing we got on my gear stick here, this is Gearronic, means it's part of it can be used in a manual way. So all I do, I'm driving along in D, which is the normal automatic position, and we're doing about 20 miles an hour. I can then knock it into the manual mode, then select the appropriate gear for the speed, which happened to be second gear, and then I can just control it manually. I'm going into first gear manually, there, like that, second gear. And we're stopping again, so I'm just going to put it back into D. It wasn't the best place to demonstrate it, really, but it can work anywhere. Let's have a look. Okay, I'll do it from here. We're in first gear. Now it's manual mode. Totally manual. Here we are. Second gear. Third gear. Fourth gear. We're doing 35. Fifth gear, and then we're slowing back down again. I'll put it back into D, because that's how I normally drive. Little thing up here, we've got a sunroof. So, if I press it there, it's a tilt slide electric sunroof, so we can come up, we can come down. One touch will take it all the way back. There we go. No, the satchel bringer all the way to the lock position. On the, we've also got a light-sensitive rear view mirror. There's a little thing at the top that says NW, which stands for Northwest. We're going Northwest. And in other words, it's an electronic built-in compass on the glass. Pretty handy sometimes when you're not quite sure whether you're going north, south, east or west. It does happen sometimes. Well, with me it does, anyway. You can deactivate that if you want to do it. Well, that's pretty much it. Oh, we've got heated seats as well, look. There are three different positions. As I press that button, three different levels of heat, of time, that is, there. So we've got the passenger and the driver. But it's not just the bottom part, it's the back part. So if you suffer from back problems, it's quite good because it can warm your back as well. As well, these seats have lumbar support, left and right. Not left and right backs, but I mean left and right seats. Okay, and that's... Oh, what else? Yes, we've got the little trip computer here. It tells you miles per gallon, average speed, and stuff like that. Well, that's pretty much it. I'm just going to look for a place to slow down and stop, and I think I found one. There we are. Turn left here. Accelerating effortlessly. And we shall stop here at the newsagent. Stop. Put it in the park. That's my special electronic button over there. And that's pretty much it. Well, thanks very much for watching. Bye-bye.